Welcome to Kelme, the land of idyllic Lithuanian countryside, rich with cultural and natural heritage. You'll find Kelme district in the west of Lithuania in the region of Žemaitija. It is 2.5 hours away from the capital Vilnius and 1.5 hours away from the port city Klaipeda by the Baltic Sea. The population of Kelme district reaches around 25,000 in 2021. Kelme seems to be just what a Lithuanian would imagine for its countryside. Beautiful rivers, lakes and forests, manor houses here and there, all of this together, a home that brings up bright minds for the Lithuanian culture. In Kelme there are 2 regional parks, numerous manor houses and even a 17th century monastery, one of the most beautiful examples of Baroque architecture in Lithuania and most famous touristic site in Kelme district. But more about it in the end of the video, so keep watching. Let's start our journey in Kražiai town. It's a historical town, mostly known for its college, established in 1614 by Jesuit monks. This college was the main educational center in the whole of Savogytia district until the middle of 19th century, and its library collection was one of the largest in the whole Grand Duchy of Lithuania. However, Kražiai has some dark history too. Today Kražiai is remembered as a place of Kražiai massacre, which happened in 1893. Because the Tsarist Russian government wanted to close down the monastery. A lot of people died then, but their sacrifice wasn't in vain. The event brought a lot of attention to the Russian anti-Catholic actions, and it became an inspiration for anti-Tsarist movement, further developing the Lithuanian national consciousness. Today, Kražiai College is a museum and a culture center. There you can learn all about Kražiai and see a book made of iron, the heaviest in Lithuania. The cultural center is very active and organizes various events and even a yearly Kražiai town festival. Next we go to Užventės town and the grounds of its manor house with its rich history. It is a large place with numerous buildings, including a brewery, blacksmith and a water mill. The manor is mentioned since the 14th century, and for a few centuries it was owned by the Grand Dukes of Lithuania. Most of its buildings are still used and the wooden manor house is inhabited by locals. Yet there also is an ethnographical museum in the barn, where you can learn about Užventės region. But the star of the grounds these days is the watermill and distillery. Besides being a hotel with a spa, it is also popular for various cultural events. Užventės manor house is also famous for being a childhood home of a famous writer Šatrijos Ragana, the Witch of Šatrija. One of her popular works is about this manor house, and an alley of linden trees mentioned there is still standing today. The whole area surrounding the grounds of Užventės manor is a great park to walk around, with beautiful landscape and numerous sculptures. So, after we found some of the literary secrets in Kelme district, we move on to the next manor house close by, Beržienai. However, this one is not looked after. Beržienai manor house is derelict now, but it is still grand. It was built in 19th century in neo-Gothic style. It had seen great days, but just as every manor house in Lithuania, it was taken over by the Soviet government. However, the last owner managed to give away many of its valuables and artworks to museums around Lithuania. For now, we can just walk around its grounds and wonder if it will be revived one day. Next, we go to see more of the natural sites in Kurtuvėnai Regional Park. We will talk a lot more about this regional park in Šiauliai district, because it has more of it, but there is still a lot to see in Kelme district too. First, we go to a curious place called Svilė sources. It's a water stream with more than 100 sources coming out of the ground, and you can see them bubbling there. We are the largest by surface area in Lithuania, covering almost 2 hectares of land. You can see some of them from a pier made for visitors. Locals use water for drinking and cooking, as it is clean and not very strongly mineralized. However, we also notice that probably because of the climate change, the sources are reducing in size in recent years. To see more Kurtuvėnai Regional Park, there are 2 cognitive trails. One is called the Juodlė Lake Cognitive Trail, 4.5 kilometers path around the lake and the swamp. The lake itself is one of the favorite bird gathering places in the regional park, so there also are some spots for bird watching. Another cognitive trail is in Vainagai village and leads through a 4.3 kilometer path around Vainagai Landscape Reserve, with beautiful forest, lake views and even a hill fort. After seeing some nature, let's finally see the district capital Kelme. It was established in 15th century, but expanded the most in 19th century when a road was built from Tilje to Riga and passing straight through the town. Kelme also has a manor house known since the town's establishment, and since 16th century up until Second World War, it was owned just by one family, Gruszewski. The house you see today was built in 18th century in Baroque style, which is rare in Lithuanian countryside. There also are a few other buildings left, including a large gate tower, which used to have a library on the second floor. The manor house is famous for being the place where the Lithuanian rebellion against the Tsarist Russia began in 1831, and the owner at the time, Julius Gruszewskis, was one of the main organizers in the Western Lithuania. Unfortunately, neither this nor the next rebellion after 30 years were successful. Today, Kelme Manor House is a regional museum, so there you can find out all what happened to Gruszewski family and more about Kelme. But the museum also has something no one would ever expect to see in a provincial manor house in Lithuania. It is an exhibition about North American native tribes. This is the only museum in Lithuania that has something about them. The story behind this is quite simple. A translator lived in Kelme who was the first to translate into Lithuanian the books written by Carl May, a German writer famous for his stories about Native Americans. So his fans had an idea to introduce Lithuania to their culture by including an exhibition in Kelme Museum. There is one more museum in Kelme with an unusual exhibition. It is a museum of sticks. One man with a passion for woodworking, Mečislavas Ežerskis, has created more than 3,700 unique sticks. Wishing to show his work to more people, he opened a small museum inside his house, currently displaying 1,200 sticks. You can also see more traditional art if you visit Kelme during a yearly festival of arts, usually held in the end of May. Next, after a short drive from the city, we stop at Burbaičiai Hillfort. It is beautifully settled on the riverbank and it is a great place to enjoy some nature. There are picnic tables, a large playground, and a bridge over the river. Occasionally, there are some local events there too. From here, we finally enter Tytuvėnai Regional Park, most appraised touristic site in Kelme district. It has the largest part of the park, although some of it is also in Radviliškis and Raseini districts. The regional park is famous for Tytuvėnai Monastery, and in nature for its chain of lakes and cranes that inhabit them. You can get to know a lot of its nature while walking its trails. First, we go to a cognitive trail with interesting rock combinations. As old as Ice Age, thousands of rocks formed some sort of strips or lines in that area. In Lithuanian, the place is called Akmenų Rūža, and the trail provides not only lots of rocks to look at, but also there are interesting sculptures for the whole family to enjoy, and it is only 1.5 kilometers long. A second cognitive trail takes you around Gilius Lake. A 3 kilometer long path shows beautiful and changing landscape surrounding the lake. On the way there are some beaches, but the water is usually cold because of many streams entering the lake. And the third trail is a short recreational path on the shore of Bridvaišis Lake. It is a great place to enjoy the lake without walking a lot. Furthermore, there is Bridvaišis Hillfort there, so you can climb it for even better views. One more place to get some views of a regional park is at Tytuvėnai Observational Tower. Although quite short, just at 16 meters height, it gives a nice higher ground to look around the regional park. And if you want to know all there is about the regional park, go to its visitor center located in Tytuvėnai town nearby. But Tytuvėnai itself is famous for something else, the Tytuvėnai Monastery. Really a Baroque gem hidden deep in Lithuanian countryside, but known by many in Lithuania. The monastery was built in early 17th century, and it actually has a mix of styles for which it is so valued. The styles being mostly Baroque, but also with some Gothic, Renaissance and Rococo influence. The monastery includes flamboyantly beautiful Church of St. Mary, a small chapel of the Holy Stairs, minimalist monk quarters and beautiful arcade galleries surrounding the inner yard. Walking these galleries feels like being somewhere in Southern Europe, but without the need of actually getting there. The monastery is very popular for pilgrimage. It is a part of Lithuania's St. Jacob's Route, and there is a pilgrim center inside, which provides accommodation, excursions, and more. So to summarize, I can only say that Kelme district really exceeded my expectations with its history, cultural heritage, and natural sites. I would definitely recommend it to visit for you if you want to see some regional Lithuania and its countryside. In the beautiful Venta, Kražant and Dubysa rivers, Kelme district is possible to explore also during a kayaking trip. See you in Kelme district. Thanks for watching.